Guru, 12 days after the Ballon d'Or lake caught fire, the lake catches fire all over again. And the fire has now been doused, but what we see there is a lake full of sewage, chemical effluents and construction debris. In fact, the last time that the fire caught, it actually blazed on for over 28 hours. So this has become a perpetual problem there in Bengaluru. The lakes are in a pathetic condition despite several warnings by the NGT, despite the outrage by environmentalists. Nothing seems to have changed. Ballon d'Or lake catches fire once again within a fortnight. Srija joining me on the phone line with more information on this. Srija, at the moment what we are looking at is a huge environmental hazard. This has become a health and sanitation nightmare. How are the citizens impacted, and what exactly have the authorities done to restrict this problem?
Well, absolutely. It was just a couple of days ago. We did, of course, see how the National Green Tribunal had drafted the civic bodies once again, asking them to, in fact, bring out an action plan and what were the measures that were taken so far. And remember, the case has also been adjourned to 28th of February. But as far as citizens are concerned, the situation continues to remain. Another point to be noted, Afridi, over here, is just a couple of weeks ago, we did, of course, show viewers as to how the fire was raging on this particular lake. And soon after that, we did not see anything much being done on ground, because remember, even after an action plan was submitted before the National Green Tribunal, talking about de-weeding, that process is still yet to start. So as far as the fire that we are looking at is the peat, which has gone up in flames, which is clearly the coir and as well as the water hyacinth. And this is clearly the reason for the cause of the fire. And the National Green Tribunal has now asked the Karnataka State Pollution Control Board to issue directions to all the apartments, that is 99 apartments, within the vicinity of the Ballon d'Or lake. But also, right, questions as far as the apartments are concerned, we are only looking at nearly 2% of the pollution as far as the apartments are concerned. But what about the industries? There are nearly 488 industries and nearly 480 million liters per day of sewage flows into that particular lake. Now, it remains to be seen, and we will have to wait and see what the National Green Tribunal will take up as far as the case is concerned.
All right. And like you said, we have to question the authorities. Are these lakes going to become a dumping ground for industrial waste? Karnataka is going into elections this year, so citizens, watch out to what the authorities and what the government is doing to give you clean, breathing air. Thanks, Srija, for joining us with your inputs on this.